Hello everyone, welcome back to Shayla's Voice. For today's video, I'll be talking about self-stimulating behavior, or stimming as we say in the autism community. Before I get into it, if you haven't already done so, please like and subscribe and hit that notification bell. When a video gets uploaded, you will be one of the first people to be notified. Stimming. Stimming is self-stimulating behavior. These behaviors can be in the form of movements or even vocals. Everyone stims in some way or the other, but sometimes it's just not clear. Stimming is very common in kids with autism because of the repetitive behaviors. Stimming isn't necessarily a bad thing, but in some cases, it can impact the quality of life of a child. Shayla has a number of different stims. Some of them are harmless, as well as some of them are dangerous. Shayla has a number of different stims, which include a little bit of rocking, a little bit of hand flapping. She loves to jump, so she's always jumping. She has a hand wringing. She also does teeth grinding. Shayla also does wrist biting. Shayla does head banging. Sometimes we find as well, she is always up close and personal. We call it affectionate, but I believe that is one of her stims, as well as she will try to find some corners sometimes and just put her head in a corner all by herself. As I mentioned, some stims can be dangerous. For example, with Shayla's hand biting, her wrist biting, we have to put a wristband on her to avoid her breaking her skin. It got to the point where she bit herself so often that her skin started to harden and turn dark. So ever since we started putting that wristband on her, she's been fine. No broken skin, and the skin has improved a lot. So it's not something that we see very often. Sometimes we see it mostly when she's frustrated. So she's trying to express herself and she can't really do it, so she bites her wrist. The same goes for when she slaps her head. Usually when she's frustrated is when we would see this behavior. Or her hand wringing, this is the one that we see most common, most often. She does it every day, all day long. She does tend to break it sometimes when she needs to eat. Sometimes we forcefully break it when she needs to do her tasks or carry on with her schoolwork, for example. It's always very, very hard to break it. And when we do break it, it breaks for a few seconds and she goes right back into it. Even when Shayla has broken that grasp, her fingers are still flickering. So that's one as well. So when her hands are not together, her fingers are going. Another thing that she does is teeth grinding. Teeth grinding we find a lot and most often when she's ready to go to bed. So when she's really, really tired, we would have the teeth grinding. Again, we spoke with her dentist. Everything's fine there. So it's not something that we try to prevent or try to step in and mitigate. Her jumping is something that we see quite often as well. She loves to jump. She jumps on everything, on the couch, on the bed. She has two trampolines. She's always jumping, always moving. So again, trying to get some sort of sensory input, and that's the way she gets it. Self-stimulating behavior basically comes around when our kids are lacking some sort of sensory input. So there's something that they're seeking and that they're needing, and this is the only way to actually get that feeling and fill that void for them. So not necessarily something that's dangerous or something that's bad. It's just that they're needing something, and it's very difficult for us to determine what they're needing, even though we try to duplicate the behavior or replicate the behavior, copy the behavior. We can't do it. We still can't tell what they're needing. They're the ones feeling it. They're the ones seeking it. So that's why most times I don't tend to break Shayla's behaviors. I just let her be, because at this moment, she's seeking and needing something. Although self-stimulating behavior is very common in kids with autism, not all the behaviors are the same. Some kids would have the rocking and the hand flapping. That's very common. With Shayla, she has a breathing stim. And again, we don't see that often. It's something brand new. We don't even know where it came from. It just happened all of a sudden. It is worrisome because it's her breathing. It almost seems like she's hyperventilating. So that is not something that you would want to continue. That is something that would definitely worry you, but we don't know how to control it. And again, because she's seeking something and needing something, this is the way that she's soothing herself. So for now, it happens. So what are your kids' stimming behaviors? Are they the common ones like the hand flapping or the rocking? Leave a comment below, because we would definitely like to know. Well, thank you for taking this journey with us. We appreciate having you. Again, if you haven't already done so, please like and subscribe. Hit the notification bell. When a video gets uploaded, you will be one of the first people to know. We will see you soon. Take care.